Guys, let us just look at the diagnosis, lab diagnosis of filariasis. Basically, they are telling that you should collect the blood as much as possible in the night, because these worms will show nocturnal periodicity. Okay, so they come out from the lymph, they will come to the blood at night, right? And when the person sleeps, that is when they come out. Not that it is in the night, but when the person sleeps. So if it is better if you take the blood sample at that time. So this is how the microfilaria is in the blood film. Microfilaria for Wuchereria bancrofti, guys. See, there is no nucleus in the tail. No nuclei in the tail. Brugia Malayi, which also can cause lymphatic filariasis. It seems to have two nuclei here. Lower doesn't, has a lot of nuclei. Okay, till the end. Just remember Wuchereria bancrofti and Brugia Malayi, you have to remember for lymphatic filariasis. Like, you can even demonstrate microfilaria in the chylous urine. So let's write this down. Microfilaria can be demonstrated in chylous urine. C-H-Y-L-O-U-S. Chylous urine. Okay. Even in this, you can demonstrate the microfilaria. So that will all be direct evidence, right? So you are demonstrating, detecting the microfilaria. There is thick and thin blood smear stain with Jimsa stain, and you will check for this microfilaria. What are you checking for? Microfilaria. You're not going to see the adult worm or something. They're talking only about the microfilaria. If you want the want to see the adult worm, then what you should do? You should take lymph node biopsy, or you have to X-ray, or you have to do some ultrasound Doppler, etc. So adult worms have a distinct pattern of movement called as filarial dance sign. So they are dancing in the lymph nodes, it looks like, in the lymph vessels. Okay, then we are done with direct. Let's move on to indirect now. Indirect means you'll find eosinophilia, serum IgE levels are elevated. Okay. Immunodiagnosis, you will do antigen detection, antibody detection, right? It's a very typical ELISA, ICT, same thing. Here, antibodies, you're detecting what? You'll detect antibody. These have low sensitivity and specificity. Then coming to molecular diagnosis, same PCR, all that you will write. PCR. Done by PCR. See, they have not mentioned here, but there is something called as a DEC provocation test. A small dose of diethyl carbamazine induces microfilaria to appear in peripheral blood even during daytime. So blood samples can be collected 20 to 15 minutes after administration of 100 milligram of tablet of DEC to adults. Let's just write that down here. See, instead of doing this, you can also do a DEC provocation test for adult. You can give 100 mg DEC, collect blood after 20 to 50 minutes, and you should be able to see these microfilaria. Okay, microfilariae appear in peripheral blood. Okay, so that is also a part of lab diagnosis. Yes, we are done with lab diagnosis. Just the filariasis, the lymph you have caused by Wuchereria bancrofti and Brugia malayi. Okay, then Brugia timori. This is because of Culex mosquito bite. This is because of Mansonia mosquito bite. You will treat same thing, DEC, diethyl carbamazine. Look at this, guys. This is the lymph. Who and all attacks the lymphatics? The Wuchereria bancrofti, the nematodes which attack the lymphatics. Okay, their habitat is the lymphatics. You have Wuchereria bancrofti, Brugia malayi, Brugia timori. Okay, then what else is there here for us to look at? Filarial nematodes affecting humans. Who and all are affecting lymphatic filariasis? Means these three you have to write. Wuchereria bancrofti, Brugia malayi, Brugia timori. Okay, the location of the adult. Location in adult body. Okay. Then microfilaria will be in the blood. Yes. Characteristics, we told you. Wuchereria bancrofti, it is pointed, tall tip, free of nuclei. There is no nuclei in this. In Brugia malayi, there will be two terminal nuclei. Brugia timori, longer than what? MF malayi. What is MF? Microfilaria of Malayi, it is going to be longer than that. That's it. Okay. All of these have nocturnal periodicity. Yes. And the vector they have told you. This one is Culex, Mansonia. This is Anopheles. Okay. All are because of mosquito only. What other type of filariasis you can have? Subcutaneous filariasis, serous cavity filariasis, etc. Okay. Let's move on then. What else is there? How, this is some community medicine stuff. How will you eliminate the filariasis? Globally, they have global program for elimination of lymphatic filariasis. Under that, you have mass drug administration. They will give DEC with albendazole, ivermectin or albendazole combination they can give. They want to alleviate suffering by morbidity management, disability prevention, because these people, their legs are so swollen, looks like, right? So in the exam, they can ask you mass drug administration. So you'll have to say DEC is given to almost everyone in the community, irrespective of whether they have the disease manifestations or not, right? Except for those people who are under 2 years or pregnant or seriously ill. So most adults they will give, and children above 2 years, you can remember. So what is the dose also? We told you 6 milli, in the treatment you have seen 6 milligram per kg body weight. Okay. So you can combine it with albendazole and ivermectin, right? So albendazole, ivermectin. Then what else is there? In India, they call it as accelerated plan for elimination of lymphatic filariasis. Guys, focus. So here they have triple drug therapy. Same thing, DEC, ivermectin, albendazole. Then community engagement. Oh, you just elaborate on that. What is this DEC medicated salt? Common salt medicated with 1 to 4 gram of DEC per kg has been used for filariasis control in Lakshadweep Island. Okay. After an initial reduction in prevalence. Okay, so this just remember this. In Lakshadweep Island, they have tried this. Common salt. Common salt also has a medicine. I kind of don't like that, but anyways, we should make sure that we don't use it by mistake. What do you say? So common salt medicated with 1 to 4 gram of DEC per kg has been used for filariasis control in Lakshadweep Island. Can you understand why Lakshadweep? Because it is coastal, right? After an initial reduction in prevalence has been achieved by mass or selective treatment. So after mass therapy, after selective therapy, then only they are doing this. Okay. Then what else? Prophylaxis also is there. You what will you do? Put mosquito net and sleep. Okay. That's it. What else we can do? Look at this. Key points. Adult worm is white, thread-like with smooth cuticle and tapering end. White is it? It is. Female worm is viviparous, so it will give what? It will give microfilaria, it will not lay egg. And for Wuchereria bancrofti, the tail tip free of nuclei, it is actively motile. It is showing nocturnal periodicity, definite host is man, intermediate host is the Culex fatigans. Microfilaria do not multiply in man, yes. They go to mosquito, there they will become third stage filariform larva, which is the infective form for us again. Okay. Pathogenesis, it will cause mechanical blockage of lymphatic system, allergic manifestation that you saw in occult filariasis. Then clinical features, what and all are the clinical features, guys? Early stage, they'll have fever, malaise, urticaria, that is hives, right? Then some swelling, lymphangitis, chronic stage, lymphadenitis, lymphangiovarix, chyluria, hydrocele is something that is affecting the scrotum, isn't it? Swelling of the scrotum. So hydrocele is swelling of the scrotum. Remember, if I put that photo, then YouTube will block this video. So scrotum, okay. Then elephantiasis, that photo you have seen. This is elephantiasis, right? Tropical pulmonary eosinophilia due to hypersensitivity. Yeah, this is the occult one. Diagnosis, how will you diagnose? Peripheral blood, urine, chylous urine, just tell that you have to take nocturnal blood. Adult worm, you can see in biopsy of lymph node, Doppler, ultrasound, x-ray, you can see the adult worm. You can try to demonstrate the antigen and antibody. Okay, treatment, DEC, ivermectin, supportive and surgical management in some cases. Okay, so we have completed lymphatic filariasis, mainly Wuchereria bancrofti. Okay, lymphatic filariasis can be because of Wuchereria bancrofti or two other things, that Brugia and all that. So we have covered almost everything, right? Look at this, human filariform infections. What is this? Wuchereria bancrofti, Brugia malayi, Brugia timor. Same thing only, right? These three are lymphatic filariasis. So these three we have finished. Okay, lymphatic filariasis we are done with. That's all, guys, in this video. We'll meet you in the next one. Bye-bye.